Hello, it's Maxine Kay from the Greater Philadelphia Center for Spiritual Living without yoga on my lap right now because she said, no, Mom, I'm not making any movies with you tonight. I'm tired and I'm going to bed. She's a very smart young lady. So, it's almost New Year's. Tomorrow is New Year's Eve. And so many people have many different ways to complete a year and to bring in a new year. We talked a little bit about this the other day. We just had a wonderful evening with some very, very dear friends. And it seems as though we've had a number of opportunities just the last few days to connect with dear friends and to celebrate coming together through this year and maintaining a sweet friendship and appreciating one another and appreciating that we're healthy and that we're wise and that we've been doing the right things to stay healthy. And it's just so beautiful to feel gratitude for the dear people in our lives and to include them in year-end festivities. Now, we're not going to be having the big New Year's Eve parties in our country or in the world probably, for the most part. Some people will, but I think for the most part, people are going to be doing more like Reverend Michael and I will be doing, which is just a quiet evening at home together, doing a little contemplation, expressing a little appreciation for the year that's been, and some hopefulness, in fact, a sense of really co-creating an inspired future for the year we're about to enter into. I'm going to give you a commercial right here. And that is that tomorrow morning, Friday morning, December 31st, we're inviting you to come to the center in person, with your mask, of course, but in person at about 6:45 tomorrow morning, because right at 7 o'clock, we're going to be entering into our beautiful time of co-creating peace in the world through the World Peace Meditation. So join us, and then you know what we're gonna do afterwards? Of course you do. We're gonna go out to breakfast all together and just really celebrate the fact that we've completed this year in a very mindful and a very meaningful and a very heartfelt and a very appropriate and workable way by ending it with peace so that we can enter the new year with what? Peace. You know, we're gonna take with us into the new year our consciousness from this past year, which is why it's a very wonderful thing to let go of all of those things for which we are really complete, those things we're ready to give thanks for and let go, to make room within our hearts and our souls and our consciousness for the new idea, for this inspired new possibility that we're co-creating. If we end a year in anger, we'll begin the year, the new one, in the same way. Now, let's not do that. Let's not drag the past in to the present and the future. If we begin the year with gratitude, it's because we've completed the year with gratitude, and that's what we're all about, isn't it? We complete the year in peace, as we'll do tomorrow morning, with people all over the world in consciousness, all at the same time, Greenwich Mean Time. I don't know why they call it Mean Time. I think it's a lovely time. I have an audience. But it's the same time all over the world. Here, of course, it is. It's going to be at 7 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, which is a lot more civilized than when we were on the West Coast, isn't it? So we're looking forward to it. It's going to be very, very special. It will be a time of prayer, a time of joining together in meditation, contemplation, and just being together will be a beautiful thing. So let's complete the year in the way that we wish to enter the new year. With a heart that is open and filled with gratitude, with a mind that is clear and clearly focused on our new intentions, and with a soul that is so ready to continue to learn and to grow and to rejoice and to live from a consciousness of joy and a sense of well-being. That's how we're going to enter into this new year. So I'm grateful that we have an opportunity to stay with you every day, one way or another. Monday through Friday, of course, it's Reverend Mike and I taking turns. And, of course, you're going to get to hear from him tomorrow. I'm sure he will be wound up and ready after that wonderful meditation tomorrow morning. And then, of course, he'll be doing his regular Science of Mind book study on Saturday morning. That will be wonderful to be back to that after our break for Christmas. And then Sunday, be sure and come to the center if you're in the area and you can do it at 10:30 on Sunday morning. We're going to have a beautiful new beginning. It's the first Sunday of January of the brand new year 2022 coming up. So I want you to practice writing 2022. So you don't put the old one in. I don't think there's too much danger of that because we're so ready, even with the new strains of things. We're ready for a new experience, aren't we? We're ready to move beyond and into something that we are co-creating, something that's called a world that works for all. Let's all do our part. Let's bring joy. Let's bring celebration. And this Sunday, not only is it wonderful that it's the very first Sunday of the year, but it's also our burning bowl. This is an opportunity to continue the releasing of the year that has been and to set the intention for the year to come. We're going to be writing on little pieces of flash paper the things we're ready to release. And we're going to put them into the burning bowl and watch them disappear. It's a wonderful visual. It's really a very effective one. And then we'll pick up a fortunate cookie from the bowl of fortunate cookies, where you will find inside at least an affirmation for the year. Just a one short, powerful affirmation that will be just the right one for you because you're going to pick it. And it will be something that you can think about and perhaps set an intention for the year to come. So we love you. We look forward to seeing you every day in one way or another. Sometimes it's just within our hearts. Sometimes it's through the love notes. Sometimes it's on the website. And you know, you can go to cslphilly.org. And not only can you go to our live stream on Sunday mornings by pressing that button that takes you right there, but you can press the same orange button at any time of the day or night and watch our archived Sunday morning celebrations, our archived love notes, and don't forget to look again at our solstice celebration. It's there too, and it's beautiful, and it is worth looking at. So that's it for now. We adore you. We appreciate you. Let's end this year together in a most beautiful, peaceful, loving, grateful way and enter into the newness with joy in our beloved community. Bye.